清汤呢，就是达到我们的感官要求，要看起来犹如一碗白开水。清汤啊，只是川菜当中独有的一门这个吊汤的一个技艺，其他菜系当中很少用到。它是制汤里面，就是说，最顶级的一个工艺了。This
is 邓代明. He's a Sichuan native who helms Dengji Sichuan, a restaurant in Hong Kong serving up classics from the region. He's known for using clear broth in a dish called Kai Shui Bai Cai, or boiled water cabbage. That's because the broth has to be so transparent it looks like water.
白菜的精髓，平淡无奇，听名字平淡无奇，它这个菜也平淡无奇，但是它的这个美味就在这个平淡无奇的汤中能够体现。吊汤这个开水里面啊，用到了四种肉，就是猪肘子、老母鸡、老母鸭，还有金华火腿，这几种肉味融合在一起的一个美味，无鸡不鲜，无火腿不美，无鸭不香。
Deng says the dish was created during the Qing Dynasty. A royal chef wanted to impress the emperor, and he did. The emperor loved it so much, he added it to the royal menu.
然后一直延续到现在，我们接待外宾，中国国宴菜。整个制汤这个过程，从这个准备原材料，到这个达到我们要求的一锅清汤出来，要7到8个小时。 首先呢，第一步呢就是原材料的初加工，老母鸡、鸭子、猪肘子、火腿，它们都要剁成大块。就是说这个屁股啊，不能要；这个你看鸡屁股、鸭屁股，为什么呢？它这个里面有这个三味啊。然后就是用水把血水冲掉，冷水下锅里面，再焯水，把血沫啊这些啊全部把它焯掉，清洗完了过后。 再放在一个桶里面进行一个至少6个小时的一个熬制。最开始就是先用猛火把这个汤烧开，然后就要调小火，保持这个汤微开，就是再煮就跟鱼在下面鼓泡一样。然后做出来这一桶汤，大概就是出个40份。就这个汤里面啊，我们要达到的标准是。 要没有油，上面一点油都没有，所以我们在煸熬制的过程当中，我们要打去这个浮沫，打去这个油。熬制完了过后，就要把这个汤过滤。过滤出来过后，就用那个猪肉蓉，加点水，在那个猪肉蓉里面加点姜，加点葱，加料酒。Making
this soup is like making consommé without the egg whites. The ground pork contains protein. As the soup heats up, the protein traps impurities in the broth. The meat will rise to the surface. You skim it off, and the soup that's left is clear.
火开始也是要大，然后开了过后呢，它浮沫浮上来过后，就要开稍微小一点的火，再去煮半个小时，然后完了把这个肉末打起来。
The key is to wait for the ground pork to rise to the surface with the scum. And not be tempted to stir it.
再用鸡肉末，然后再进行第二次的这个清汤，才能达到这个清澈如水。Second
round makes the soup even clearer and brightens up its color. Finally, they add Chinese cabbage.
白菜选用的是新鲜嫩的黄秧白菜。白菜啊，我们只要这个新的部分。 啊，这个心比较嫩，我们就只要这一点就够了。The
cabbage is blanched for about a minute before it's tossed into ice water.
放在冰水里是为了保持它的这个鲜艳程度，它不变颜色。哇，我们还要把它改刀焯形，然后用保鲜膜封住，再蒸1分钟。 一道好的开水白菜，首先要达到就是这个汤要清澈如水，颜色要达到一个淡茶色。I
don't think this is like polite in Chinese.
Okay, let's try.
Yeah, basically you can taste
every single element. This is incredible.
I want to try the cabbage.
And you're like, okay, it's going to taste like water, right? Like hot water. And then it's like bursting with flavors. It's like a firework in your mouth.
Deng said his master taught him how to make this dish only after working for him for 2 years.
我是16岁学厨，18岁才接触制糖。最开始师傅进厨房学习的时候，我们就叫那个时候叫打杂工。师傅不可能让你来学这些东西的，因为做汤是专门的有人做的，不是谁都可以去做这个汤的。清汤是最后一步让你接触，让你去做的。
Up next, a 30-year kitchen veteran shows us how to wield a knife in Huayang cuisine. Stay tuned.